What's going on? SARKAZZ here. Welcome back to my channel. This is another Q&A. Thank you to those who submitted their questions. Again, if you're trying to, you know, ask me something, always check out the community tab, because who knows when I feel like doing a Q&A. You can drop your questions. Anyway, let's get into it. We're going to go from the latest to the most current. Goodman TV, you always ask me this question, but I'm going to answer once again. What cameras are you using to do... These are vlogs. A blog, remember, there's a difference between a blog and a vlog. A vlog is video blogging, and a blog is just written, you know, yeah. So what I use to do my vlogs are, right now I'm filming on the Canon M50. I use the G9X, the G7X, the M6. And that, I forgot what that other little point and shoot one is. But I interchange, depends on the mood I am, which camera I use. But like for most, like a sitting video like this, I use the M50. The G7X is more the, you know, vlog, you know, it's smaller. Like the last vlog I did was on the M50. What I don't like, you know, because like you want to capture something quick, I like the M50 and it has a lens. But for vlogging out on the go, I don't like to have to keep taking a lens on and off. And I wouldn't leave it off because the lens of the camera could get scratched up. But yeah, so those are the cameras that I use for vlogging. I'm a Canon head. For my birthday, I'm about to treat myself to a Panasonic Lumix. I'm a Canon head, but I do a travel camera, and that's a camera I had my eye on for a while. So yeah, I'm gonna get that for myself for my birthday. And it's a camera, it's under $400. Yeah, you don't have to spend a lot of money to get a good camera, good quality. Just do your research. There's a whole lot of YouTube. Research. Simply being supreme. Hey, hun, my question is, what made you start vlogging? I've answered this before, but I'm going to go a little bit... Well, yeah, let's see. So, when I've been doing YouTube for over 10 years, and I started off with doing LGBT topic videos, because, you know, I saw them going around, I'm like, I got opinions too, and so I jumped in on that. Then, you know, I like singing, so then I did singing videos. But as time went on, and I said it before, how much gay shit can you talk about? And I'm like, And you're getting old, it's like, You know, there's a way you could incorporate everything, but not just, you know, just geared towards that. And I thought, like, what could I do? You know, I've thought about all the different trends that go on, you know. Doing all these challenges, and you know, when I was in relation, in relation, doing couples. Nah, man, that's just never been my thing. So I thought, like, what is to be the best thing to stay in my lane, be true to myself, and enjoy this vlogging. And with that, you know, it's just every day. For me, you know, I know some vloggers. It's nothing wrong with that, but it's just not my lane. Like, this, let me just use Casey Neistat, for example, or what's his name? McKinnon? I forgot his first name. It's just slipping my mind right now. But they go out and do things to make a video. Like, going jumping off cliffs or going riding through the patches and shit. I'm not doing all that. I'm sharing everyday life. If you want to watch, you watch. If you find it interesting, great. Thank you for being here. But I'm just about sharing everyday life, and everyday life can be interesting. It may seem boring. You know, I hear people, they want to start vlogging. Oh, my life is... No. Somebody's going to watch. So that's how I got started into vlogging. And I really enjoy doing it, if you can't tell. And I like that I can reflect back from where I've come from to where I am now. And what's her name? It's skipping me right now. You in Hawaii. Oh, God. Your name is slipping me right now. But... She, you know, she's been going back and watching my videos from years past, and, you know, with different comments. And it feels good to know, to hear someone say, wow, I see the growth from when you... So, yeah, it's good that, you know, because people have been watching me for a minute, and you can see the growth and the changes and stuff like that. And I just really enjoy this, and I'm just going to keep doing it until I don't feel like doing it anymore. Yeah, so I hope that answered your question. Peanut Chew, how you doing? Okay, this is a very question. What's your meaning of life? What's my That's kind of a hard question. It's broad. And how I understand how I'm taking it. Meaning, like, to me, to be happy, to be at peace. Those are the two things, to be happy and be at peace. I mean, I don't like rah, rah, rah. And I like to be happy. And those two, for me, go hand in hand. So the meaning of life for me, yes, peace and happiness. I don't know. It may sound generic, but it's really the truth. Yeah, if anyone, I don't like the rah, rah. I don't like it. So peace and happiness. We good. And some curry chicken. Yeah. Your wife's question, when you're making bracelets or videos, what's your muse? Very good question, wife. Bracelets. I just started creating bracelets. When is COVID stuff locked down? March I started. So March, April, May, June, July. So it's been 5 months I've been doing this. It's something that anyone in my life knows about me. When I say I'm going to do something, when I put my mind to something, I'm going to do it. I may say it today. It may not happen today. It may not happen next week. It may not happen next month. But it's going to happen. You know, I do believe when you put stuff into the atmosphere, when you speak stuff to the universe, yes, it happens. Whether it be good or bad, that's what, speak life into your life. So some time ago, I said, I really wanted to do that. Because, I mean, I bought braces here and there. And I wear it a couple of times because it's like, you know, I like it, but it's just not me. And so I was like, you know, I'd really like to create my own. And so I started, you know, doing it on my regular Instagram, and I was just, you know, I just bought it and just, you know, fooling around. And I put up a couple in, and when someone said, are you selling? I was like, oh, and I don't know what the heck I'm doing, but if I don't know what I'm doing and somebody want to buy it, imagine if I know what I'm doing. So I said, just give me some time. I just started, let me get more used to it. And I started watching tutorials to, you know, learn different techniques and, you know, and then just making stuff my own. Because I could watch something, but then, you know, like I watched some tutorials on be making. I'm like, oh, that's annoying. And I was like, oh, fuck it. Like, for example, when you're tying a knot and you're finishing, you're completing the bracelet, some people, they put glue on it. I started off doing that, and that shit is annoying as fuck. My fingers were, I was like, nah, bitch, this ain't right. Because, like, they say, okay, you put the glue on it, and you gotta let it sit for 24 hours. I ain't got time for that shit. No. I mean, I'm tying this, and a good-ass knot is gonna stay. So, but over time, I'm learning that there's different kind of cords, different cords, different weights. And I'm learning to, like, and I'm finding favorites. This shit is just fun. If anyone knows me, I am a creative person. I mean, from young, I was talking the other day, and I'm like, I've always been in something creative. I like to create. I mean, after a while, I do get kind of tired of something. For me, I notice I get tired when, so, for example, graphic design. I do graphic design, like anything. I do my own shit. My own tattoo, I design my own shit. Like, but doing graphic design for people now is not really that enjoyable anymore, because it's like, you know, people want to hire you to do something. You the designer, but you can't even design because they come at you with shit. And you're like, fuck, that's dumb. But they the customer, so you got to do what they got to do. So it's like, it became less, I don't really like it. I do it, but I don't really like it. So, and that's the thing, is like, anything I do, I got to enjoy it. Because I don't enjoy it, I don't want to do it. That's with everything with me. And so, you know, I've gone from graphic design, and, you know, I've had my own magazine. I used to do mixtapes. Yo, I was called, my mixtape name was Sam's Props. My shit was sold in stores. You know, when we had record stores. Record stores used to buy my mixes. Girl, I've been through a lot. I've done a lot of shit. But everything creative, I love it. You know, people saying they bored. I'm like, what you bored for? Go find something. I never bored. So when it comes to my muse for braces, I'm just creative. And it's just an outlet for me to just create. You know, and so my goal every, now mind you, I started since March. Every day my goal is, the least bracelets to create is 2, the most 7. So imagine from March till now, You know how much bracelets I make? Girl, I got a bucket full of bracelets. Because on my Instagram, all the bracelets that you see is one of a kind. And that's another thing about me. I like one of a kind pieces. I don't like to do 10 pieces and everyone got the same piece. I don't like that. You know, I like if someone wears like, oh, what's that? And you be like, oh, that's wrist at all. Oh, word. You know what I'm saying? But no one else has your, that's, I love, no one else has your piece. I mean, I do customs, great. You want something you see, you want me to tweak it a little bit, no problem. But everything you see on my Instagram, it's one of that. And I like for a person to just have one, so no one else has that. And that's just me, because that's for myself. I don't like to have everything everybody else got. You know, no, I don't like it. So yeah, I hope I'm not long-winded with everybody. That's my answer. And when it comes to videos, my muse is just life. Because that's, you know, my vlogs is just sharing life, so it's nothing, it's just life. It's everyday shit. Everyday shit. And I think, you know, being in different parts of the world, people's way of life, day of life, everything they do is different. So it's kind of interesting to watch. I mean, something to be repetitive, like I've said before, but it is what it is. When it comes to me doing reviews, my muse is, it's just truth. If y'all watch my review, I don't sugarcoat shit. They're like, you know, if I like it, I like it. I don't. But I'm going to tell you how my experience and keep moving on. So, yeah. Thank y'all for your questions. I hope you enjoyed this Q&A. Remember, check out the community tab if you're trying to ask me something. You know, that's where you're going to drop your question. And, yeah, on that note, guys, I'm out.